Why? Because I have entered into a NDA, non-disclosure agreement, and of course I have further entered into a PEA, business engagement agreement with Sahul India, a multinational company from West Bengal. So I am not in a position to disclose whatever the ingredients are, but I can tell you, I have noted is that takeaway points. It contains dye, a dyeing principle. So in my experience and whatever I collected from my traditional practitioners, Siddha traditional practitioners, dye containing plants have anti-cancer properties. This is for sure. And of course my formulations have either dye or calomel in the metal mineral thing, which I have given us takeaway points. Then development status, report and treatment with a drug. This is one of the case I treated for oral cancer. Then of course in this slide there is an ethical issue. I told the patient that I am going to take a photograph of you before and after treatment, and no need to worry, I will not disclose your name. I will simply mask your eyes so that your identity cannot be revealed. She simply said, no doctor, don't just do it. Just take me and publish me, my face. Let them, those who see, understand that I am a living example of the greatness of Siddha and Siddha medicine, anti-cancer medicine. So I have left it like this. The first one is before treatment and the other one is after treatment. Treated with the herbal medicine which I presented at the unit. Then integrative oncotherapy, another important area is integrative oncotherapy. This paper was presented at Manipal University. Of course the students, my students who presented the paper, some of them have come here, they are here, they presented posters today. So this is from our experience, clinical experience. We have two combination of two drugs, modified drugs, and we gave the drugs to patients on chemotherapy and radiation. So what the net result or what the observation we found and the patient themselves found is the side effects were reduced. See, whenever we prepare a patient for radiation or chemotherapy, they will be aware the first thing that strikes them is that hair loss, then pigmentation of the face, etc. Our herbal medicine given to cancer patients on chemotherapy and radiation reduced the side effects. Hair loss was not there, it was reduced, hair loss was greatly reduced. There was lesser pigmentation. And of course, apart from reducing the side effects of radiation and chemotherapy, the formulation itself exhibited 62.59 anti-cancer rate. So it has dual actions. And of course, it is best advised for both prophylactic and therapeutic actions. Then evidence through reverse pharmacology, we submitted it in yet another conference. Two Siddha medicines, B7 for breast cancer and KKPN for cervical cancer, they were selected and it was studied through reverse pharmacology. They were end medicines. And IC50 value for B07 is 1.429 microgram per ml. And the LD50 for cervical cancer medicine is 173.99 microgram per ml. So these are all some positive findings to indicate us that we can work further on these preparations or formulations. Then again, this is regarding polyherbal formulation for breast cancer, which I told in the previous slide, D07. And again, we focused on A549 lung carcinoma cells also. This paper was published in the Asian Journal of Pharmaceutical and Clinical Research just in this year itself, February 2017. So this shows the concentration and the inhibition, anti-cancer viability percentage. So LD50 value, we have mentioned it. This again is a positive finding that we are going in the correct direction. Again, maximum inhibition is achieved at a higher concentration of 100 microgram. least concentration is 6.25 microgram, where half of the proliferating cell would be destroyed in very lower concentration. One test drug inhibits the cell proliferation even at its lower concentration and gradually increasing at higher levels. Then takeaways. These are some takeaways I am going to give you today. In our observation and research, I have already told you the first point. The thing or the information we collected from our traditional practitioners and from our own experience in preclinical cancer screening, dye-containing plants have anti-cancer properties. And of course, in most of the Siddha anti-cancer preparations, the usage of Oma, Caraproptica, Ajwan. So, in herbal sector, and Calomel, that is Rasa Karpura, in the mineral sector, mercurous chloride have been observed. Then, Kaya Kalpa medicines are equally effective in prophylaxis and therapeutics. I stress here, Kaya Kalpa and antioxidants do have a direct and certain role in anti-cancer formulations. I said during integrative oncology, two drugs, and one drug is a known and proven antioxidant, Kaya Kalpa. The other one is a direct drug for cancer. And of course, the probable mode of action may be our anti-cancer formulation significantly decreases the level of marker enzymes and lipid enzymes and increases the level of antioxidant enzymes. That is why I stressed much on antioxidants. Then, regarding adverse effect, of course it was no significant. And of course, by means of their antioxidant and free radical quenching effects, they have definite anti-cancer effect. This is somewhat rough for a broad mode of action, according to us. Then facing the challenges, of course, we are having quite a lot of challenges before us. To face it well, to face it effectively, we have to revise our ancient methods, apply latest techniques without changing the basic concepts, then improve the quality control and quality assurance, explain our Ayush system in modern scientific language, and of course we should employ wider clinical applications for positive health, and finally, modernization is the prioritized answer for globalization. Globalization, of course, is very, very important to have a wider dissemination of our medicines and of our people. So, I have an open call, as I told in the first phase of my speech. Do you have a great and promising concept? Need not essentially be a concept, because a concept may be hypothetical. Do you have a prototype? It may be an early prototype or a late prototype. Early prototype confines itself to the lab itself. Late prototype, of course, fully functional lab prototype with some clinical evidence. Do you have such things? Then, of course, the sky will be your limit. If at all you present your concept or the prototype in the proper format to the proper people, wonders can be done. As I said, IIGP is periodically and annually calling for new innovations. They will select 50 innovations and they will give you product commercialization training at the IIT New Delhi. Then there is CII, Confederation of Indian Industries. They also call for innovations, medical innovations. Of course, the fever cluster was initially selected by CII. And I presented it at IIT New Delhi, where it was much appreciated. Then only Camtek came to know about it and they asked me to present it before them in Bangalore. I presented it in Bangalore and I was offered that great offer. So, do you have such a thing? Since you are PhDs, since you are faculties, there will be quite a lot of things to put it in the new way or to introduce or manifest it as a new drug delivery system. If you have such things or concepts or working prototypes or instruments or new drug delivery systems, of course, we are having quite a lot of opportunities. Then do you have clinically proven formulations for cancer treatment? Do you possess working prototypes? Can you design a new drug delivery system? If so, the future is certainly yours. But of course, I can give you the way to submit proposals or suggest ways. You can contact me through your institution, through your faculty members. That's all I have today. Thank you.